We live in remarkable times. Never before have we been so connected. Never before have we had the opportunity to share our ideas, thoughts, and feelings with people around the world with such ease and speed. All thanks to this, the smartphone. Did you know that the smartphone now outsells the PC? 49% of smartphones shipped in 2011 were running Google Android. And Apple sold almost 70 million iOS devices in the first 3 months of 2012 alone. Android sees 850,000 devices activated every single day. By the end of 2011, over 35 billion mobile apps were downloaded.
These devices are many times more powerful than the computer that put man on the moon. They're no longer just phones. They're our guides, assistants, advisors, our best friends. Where's the nearest coffee shop?
200 meters left.
A compromised phone can leak information about you or your business, or send secret messages to premium numbers. This kind of abuse can have serious consequences. Smartphone compromise is a reality. Trend Micro estimate that by the end of 2012, we'll see almost 130,000 unique malicious apps for Android alone, most of them SMS fraud trojans. Cybercriminals follow the money. How does malware infect your phone? Mostly because of you. Criminals are experts in social engineering, fooling you into installing their malicious creations. This is Stan. He's a criminal. He's just uploaded his latest batch of apps. That's the most common way for malware to get on your device. You download it. This is Jane, a junior account manager on her lunch break. She's downloading a new game. It's one of Stan's apps. It will secretly send premium rate text messages without her knowledge. She'll lose about $150 this month. Stan just made some easy money, but the day's not over. He's on his way to infiltrate a company. Let's follow him. Stan's researching a potential victim. Social networks, professional networks, search engines, all combined to help him create a very credible attack. Stan sends his mark a message that appears to come from his own internal IT team, letting him know where to download the new corporate messaging app. Just a few clicks and the victim installs the malware. Like most other cybercrime, it's easy, simple, and fast. The phone shows no signs of unusual activity, but it's already under the control of the criminal. Stan just got a text message that the malware has been successfully installed, and he now has remote control over the phone. He can do pretty much anything he wants. Right now, he's instructing the phone to intercept every incoming call and every incoming SMS. Stan doesn't have to stop with just calls and texts. He wants to know what's happening in the boardroom. One more SMS, and he's remotely activating the mic and recording everything. Targeted and persistent attacks are a reality, and a mobile device is often the most unprotected. Everything that's said in this room is recorded and uploaded to a server where Stan or another criminal can download it. And worst of all, these people have no idea it's happening. Stan got hold of some important information today. Information he can sell on the criminal underground, or even use himself. Corporate espionage and insider trading has never been so easy.
This kind of spyware is not science fiction, it's already a reality. This scenario is not a prediction, it's a warning. You can and should be taking the necessary steps to protect your mobile device. Always lock your device with a password. Stick to the official app distribution channels. Check the publisher and reputation of every app you download. And when you install an app, check the permissions it's asking for. And make sure that you invest in effective mobile security and management software. My name's Rick Ferguson from Trend Micro. Thanks for watching.